In this video, we want to talk about data types and what data types are. In our case, in this strategy test, we see that the local time has a special format. And whenever you calculate something, it is important to choose the right type of data type. So let's find out how to do that. We start by clicking on this little icon here, or you can also press F4. Now you should see the Metaeditor, and here you want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file SimpleDataTypes, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the OnTick function and the two command lines here. Let's start with the most obvious type of data, and that is text. In our case, we use the data type string to assign this text to a string variable that is called text. But you couldn't use them to calculate anything. If you want to calculate anything, you would need to use the right kind of value. For example, to get the balance value for our account, we use a double type. Double is a floating point type. And by using the function accountInfoDouble in combination with this expression here, it's all uppercase, we should get the right value. So let's see. We will use the command function to output the text followed by the calculated value. Let's click on the compile button here or press F7. And that should work without any errors. And if that is the case, you can click on a little icon here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. In the last video, we have learned how to use the strategy tester. So let's click on File, Strategy Tester. Here we pick the new file, Simple Data Types, and start a new test. And now you should see the value is 100,000.0. Let's change that here. Start another test, and this time you will see the digits behind the dot, and that is why we use double when we do anything with floating type values. You already know the time local function from the previous video, and that will return a variable of the type DateTime. So let's create an output for this one, recompile the code, stop the previous test and start a new one. And now you see the output is in a special kind of formatted value. So date time is what we want to use whenever we need something with time and date. For whole numbers, you can use the integer type. In this case, for the account number, we get it by using account info integer, using this constant for account login. Let's see how this looks like. And here it is. When you expect only true or false as a statement, you use the bool type. So let's see how the output for this one looks like. And now we see the output, the value is true. These have been a few common data types. If you click on Help or press F1, you should find the MQL5 reference article about data types. And you will learn that there are a few more types that you can use. Complex data types are also possible. I would suggest to write little test programs like this one, because in this little video you learned how to output different data types directly on your chart, and you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.